New details are coming out, and it's even more disturbing than most imagined. 12 News reporter Nick Bohr is just back from Sheboygan. And Nick, the woman's 13-year-old great-grandson accused of killing her with a hatchet.
And Jason, the great-grandson and his fellow eighth-grade friend are both charged with first-degree intentional homicide. Prosecutors say as unlikely as it seems, the pair went to the woman's home armed with a hatchet and hammer, intent on killing her.
The first officers on the scene Wednesday night could tell immediately just how violent the death of 78-year-old Barbara Olson was. We're only now learning how personal. Her 13-year-old great-grandson, Antonio Barbeau, is charged with conspiring with his 13-year-old friend Nathan Pape to kill and rob Olson. Investigators say the boys confessed to killing her with a hammer and hatchet, stealing her car, and dumping it in a bowling alley parking lot. Then going out for pizza before walking home.
It was obviously not only the act itself was extremely disturbing, but it was a callous, I don't understand how anyone, much less 13-year-olds, can be so unfeeling about someone to, after they kill her, go to have a pizza. It's one aspect of this case which will shock and stun the community.
It's still unclear why Barbeau targeted his great-grandmother, who wasn't discovered for 2 days. After police found the abandoned car, evidence, including a school paper with the name Nate on it, helped lead to the arrests. Kristen Carpacci is Nathan's neighbor.
Two special agents, or whoever they were, came and just asked if we had seen this car in our neighborhood, and I said no. And then that night we went to bed, and I woke up at 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning. And that's when he was being arrested.
Police searched the home, finding blood-spattered clothing, the victim's gold watch, and in a nearby storm drain, Olson's purse.
Very upsetting. I have a daughter who goes to the same school that he goes to. I've seen him several times, and it's just very upsetting, knowing that someone lives across the street is capable of something like this.
Both boys remain in juvenile detention, awaiting preliminary hearings early next month. But again, they are charged as adults. If convicted, they'd receive mandatory life sentences.